How's it going, everyone? Sensei Sebastian here. Today we are going to be covering a very important compound movement called the squat, okay? A lot of people know about the squat, but it is a very common exercise to make some key mistakes on. So we're going to go over the technique, we're going to break it down, we're going to go from our positioning to what we should be focusing on, what we should be watching out for, and we're going to go bodyweight squats. I'm also going to show you guys how to use a bar if you're going to go a little heavier, and how to use the dumbbells as well with this. So a couple different variations. But we're just going over a basic squat and gonna cover it from bottom all the way up. So to start off, okay, with the squat, very important, we're gonna start off with our feet about shoulder width apart. Okay, now when you are doing your squat, your foot positioning, it's very important to think about gripping the floor with your toes. If you're wearing shoes, same thing. It's just something you wanna think about. Squeeze the floor with those toes. Okay, now when you're here, we're gonna start with our hands out in front of us. Okay, now I'm gonna show you guys a squat at full speed and then we're gonna break it down. So a squat would come all the way down here and then right back up. Now, starting off, like I said, feet need to be planted. Now, when you guys are doing your squat, the most common mistake I typically see as a trainer is this. Knees caving in. So when your knees cave in like this, this is very, very bad on the joints, especially right in front of the knees over here. So we wanna make sure when we do compound exercises like a squat that our joints are stacked. So a stacked joint would look like this, okay? So when you're in this position, very important, you wanna think about your knees being over top of your feet. So when you're doing your squat, you wanna focus on really using the exterior of the glutes, okay, the glute meats, and pushing your knees outwards. So as you squat, don't let your knees cave in, don't let your knees fall forward, think about pushing your knees out. Okay, this way. Now from here, okay, now my knees are directly over top of my feet and I'm nice and strong in this position. My glutes are engaged, my legs are engaged, and then as I come back up, I'll be nice and strong. So the knees, very important. You wanna make sure that your knees are being pushed out to the side, not caving in and not bending forward. So a common misconception, a lot of people say push through the heels. Now, to someone, to a newer trainee, they're gonna think about doing this. They're gonna be driving their heels in the floor and lifting their toes up. So that's something you don't want to do. You wanna make sure that you're gripping the floor with your toes and that your weight is evenly centered between your heel, okay, and the front of your foot. So you should be sitting right in the middle of the foot, okay? So not back, not forward, okay? Now, very important again. So we're gonna start gripping the floor with our toes. We're gonna think about pushing our knees out. We're gonna think about keeping the weight centered and now moving on to what you're doing with your upper body. Very important, you wanna keep everything engaged. It is a compound movement, which means you're using more than one muscle group. So we're targeting legs, but your core needs to be strong and your back needs to be strong. So when you're doing your squat, think about taking a deep breath in and squeezing your core, keeping it nice and tight as you come down, pushing the knees out, okay? Now from this position, you wanna think about keeping your back and your shins parallel. So if you're leaning too far forward, okay, that's not good. If you're leaning too far back, that's when the heels come off, or the toes come off the ground and you lose balance. And when you're lifting heavy weights, that can be very dangerous, okay? So you wanna think about traveling straight down and straight back up without leaning forward, without leaning backwards, okay? So we covered our feet, gripping the floor with our toes. We talked about pushing the knees out. We talked about squeezing the core, okay? Squeezing the core will reduce the chances of doing something called a butt wink. That's when you go down, okay, and your hips curve in this way, okay? So as you go down, if you don't squeeze your core in, that's when your glutes are gonna be moving and your hips are gonna be rolling forward and rolling backwards, which is, you're gonna lose a lot of power. And once you get those numbers up with the weights, okay, that's, it's not something you want to do, all right? So very important. Toes gripping the floor, push the knees out, squeeze the core, drop straight down, keep the weight 50-50 from the front and the back, right in the middle so you're not leaning forward, keep your chest up high, keep your eyes forward. So from here, I'm gonna breathe in, squeeze the core, squeeze the legs, drop straight down, push the knees out, keep the chest up, keep the eyes forward, and drive straight back up. At this position, when you stand up, you wanna think about squeezing your hamstrings, squeezing your glutes, squeezing your quads, keeping your core tight, and then again. So I'm breathing in on the way down. Everything's nice and strong. Breathing out on the way up. and keeping everything nice and tight. So that is a bodyweight squat without any added resistance, without any added equipment. Okay, now we're gonna cover how to do a squat with a bar. So when you guys are at the gym and you guys hitting a squat with a squat rack and the heavy bar, very important that there is some key things you wanna focus on. So starting off, I'm gonna be using this bow staff because we are a karate school and we don't have any big heavy barbells, but I can show you guys the proper technique as well. So you wanna think about keeping the bar, okay, right over here, right about where your traps are. So try not to keep it too high up on the neck and not too low as well. We're gonna go right about where the traps are, gripping the bar, and you wanna think about pulling the bar into you. So in this position, your lats are nice and strong, your core is nice and strong, which is gonna add extra stability. More stability will increase your likelihood to increase your weight and your resistance. So more stability will equal more strength. So from here, okay, bar is on the traps, pulling the elbows down, keeping the lats tight, gripping the floor with my toes, keeping my eyes up and chest forward. I am going to drop down, push the knees out, keep the core tight to reduce the butt weight, and then drive straight back up. Okay, now, same thing, if you're using dumbbells, let's say we're doing a front squat with the dumbbells in this position, again, elbows tucked, lats are strong, core is tight, and same concept, everything's strong to begin with. You take that deep breath in, you squeeze your core, push the knees out, and then come right back up. Okay, so that is your squat. Again, it's a compound exercise. There is a lot that goes into it, and there's a lot of ways you can make key mistakes. To go over one more time, to recap. Feet, okay, shoulder width apart. Grip the floor with your toes. You also wanna think about torquing your knees outwards, which is gonna help you push the knees out. Okay, so from here, squeeze, drive the knees out, drop the hips straight back and down like you're sitting on an imaginary chair, keeping your core tight, keeping your chest up, keeping your eyes forward, and squeezing everything all at the same time for a perfect squat and coming right back up. Try it out, lots to think about. Think about one or two things at a time and make sure you're watching yourself in the mirror and focusing on technique. The more you do it, the more you're gonna create muscle memory, the stronger you're gonna feel, the less prone to injuries you're gonna become, and you're gonna develop an awesome, strong squat. Try it out.